tweets went out, but just trying to find the stream. I should really have charged my phone. I don't know where my charger is, actually. Just close this and reopen it, hope that that fixes it. Sorry. Sorry, still looking for it. Sometimes it's like 30 seconds, well actually that's only happened once or twice, but most times it just seems to take ages. There we go. Oh, it's went out as Parappa the Rapper. But that's fine. okay. Is that Uncle Death? On his skateboard.
In the year 2026 AD, the Earth-Rage tectonic disturbance occurred around the world, splitting the Earth into four terrestrial masses. Domination, war, disaster and famine broke out in the four lands, and mankind fell into disarray. In the center of the world, a single tower rose steeply into the sky. It was a great structure looking down upon the earth from the heavens above. People believed that it held the key to the future. It became known as the Tower of Barbs, a place at which one could come closest to God.
Another new arrival. Looks like things are about to get busy around here.
waiting for you. This is your first time riding line 15, huh? I know, it's not a very well-known line, I admit. Anyway, this is the last stop. Underwater Rolodex, and it's super important. I forgot to mention, my name is Uncle Death. I have a feeling we're gonna get along.
Soundtrack by Akira Yamaoka and the, I think, executive director, Suda 51. Goichi Suda.
Keeping in touch.
Bonus. The following items have been distributed as a reward for this event. Death Metal. Walking bonus. Thanks for playing Where to Die. This is Captain Yosuyama from the Yosuyama Enterprises Management Team. Your walking bonus for today has been sent to your rewards box. Please head over there. Cool. Just close that for now. Directional buttons to quickly switch between weapons equipped and these swords.
Yeah, you should be able to jump and shimmy up there somehow.
Rage moves. In this game you can unleash rage moves techniques which are stronger than regular attacks. If you use these effectively, you'll have an advantage in battle. Rage gauge. Each time you deal damage to an enemy, your rage will build. This will increase in level until it reaches the maximum. Activating rage moves. When the rage gauge is full, hold triangle as you attack to unleash a powerful rage move with your equipped weapon. Gauge used. Number of gauges used by the rage move depends on the weapon you're holding. There's that.
Hey, up ahead, baby. Time for some healing.
Circle. Circle as well, that's where we're going. mushrooms. You will encounter various types of mushroom in this game. They have many uses, but here we'll explain their roles as food items. Eating growing mushrooms. When you draw close to a mushroom, you can consume it quickly by selecting the eat icon, which will be displayed. Eating mushrooms in your bag. When you put mushrooms in your death bag, they'll be displayed in the flick box at the top right of the screen. Flick on the mushroom you want to eat with the touchpad and eat it by clicking the right side of the touchpad. Right, mushroom effects. Not all mushrooms are beneficial to the player. Some mushrooms contain poison resulting in death, so be careful. Chance of death.
Eat mushrooms! That's a given.
I mean, you just said that you'd maybe die if I eat them. You'll get healing for 10 seconds. Put it in the bag. Gear elements. There are 6 types of equipment: slashing, blunt, piercing, fire, lightning, and poison. Weapon types. You can hold up to 2 types of weapons at the same time. It's important to pay attention to the type of armour the enemy is wearing and manage your weapons accordingly. Armour types. Armour has a defensive value that varies with the type. It's important to pay attention to the enemy's weapons and switch accordingly.
Wanna give me some of those mushrooms?
Aye, how do we do that? How do we give you mushrooms? Throwing mushrooms, you encounter both mushrooms and beasts in this game. Let's look at how to throw mushrooms. Choose a mushroom you wish to throw by flicking the touchpad to select one. Click the left side of the touchpad to switch to throw mode. This mode you can throw mushrooms, press X. Right, so we're going to do that. Aye, because that was how we might continue the game. So flick. It changes to throw mode. Gortastic attack. When you make an enemy groggy, that's when you can unleash a gortastic coup de grace. These moves are so awesomely brutal that you might even want to cover your eyes. Making an enemy groggy. By unleashing a continuous barrage of attacks on the enemy, you can make them groggy. Of course, this can happen to your character as well, so take care. Using gortastic. By approaching an enemy in a groggy state, holding triangle and pressing an attack button, a gortastic attack activate depending on the weapon used. Gortastic experience. If you defeat an enemy using a gortastic attack, you will receive more rewards than usual. Don't hold back that.
Senpai, can't wait to see your next battle.
Ah!
Wanna try again? Oh, wait. Let me put the title logo up real quick. You know how these things go. Woohoo!
Let it die.
So I got sniped to death, and Uncle Death decapitated the sniper. How's he going to bring me back to life?
Thank you for listening to this voice guidance system. Let us embark on a journey of discovery about the many wonders of the Tower of Barbs. The Tower of Barb is located on the tiny 3.7 square mile island of South Tokyo. Legend has it that this island was formed during the Earth Rage tectonic disturbance of 2026. The tower stands at 1,686 feet, the equivalent of a 30-story building with super high ceilings. Many say that the tower is actually growing with each passing year. Legend has it that a great treasure lies at the top of the tower. As such, many brave people often attempt to climb the tower to obtain those riches. However, none have managed to survive the tower's horrific trials. And thus, the tower stands as a grim reminder of the many lives lost in search of this mythical treasure. I hope that you too will enjoy your climb of the tower and experience the many wonders that it has to offer.
Ah, finally waking up. You seem sleepy, so I turned it off. Huh? I'm talking about the Death Drive 128, of course, man. You were just playing it, remember? Hey, pretty cool, huh? Pretty badass? It's the best game console ever, and this game, Let It Die. It's probably the greatest game ever made. Yeah! The goal of the game is pretty simple. Just make it to the top of the Tower of Barbs. It's like a hack and slash, roguelike kind of a thing. What the? Hey, dude! You're a gamer, aren't you? Then you'll totally be fine. Just try it out. I'll set it up for you. Okay, all ready to go? Let's get started! I'll start the game.
So it's a blocked scene. So all that it says is news, start of service, welcome to Let It Die. Our store will be available in the coming days, so please stay tuned. Log in every day, be sure to log in every day to pick up some awesome gifts. TDM Raid Fest. Participate to win prizes weekly. Close. I wonder if the whole game is blocked now. Let's go for it. Game start.
Ugh, gross emo.
Stop of line 15, situated under the Tower of Barbs. This room contains many interesting features. Just what are you waiting for, you ask? Perhaps the question should be, what is waiting for you? Quit game. When you want to quit playing, please select back to title from the options menu when you're in the waiting room. If you quit the game outside of the waiting room, it will be treated as a death, so please be careful. Right, to remember that. Side of the touchpad to switch to throw mode. In this mode you can grill the mushroom by approaching the fire in a stage and pressing X. Some mushrooms cannot be grilled. You can also just throw them into the fire to grill them. Their effects change when you grill them, so be experimental with your cooking. Mushroom Club. This shop opens after you rescue the mushroom magistrate, the owner of the shop. They will deal with skill decals formed from mushroom powder. What are skill decals? Attaching decals to a fighter's body will benefit the player with various effects. There are many designs and functions. Once a decal is attached, if the fighter dies, or if the decal is removed, it will disappear. Purchasing you buy skill decals by using kill coins. You can sell skill decals in your possession. Since you can't get rid of them, you may as well sell those you have no use for. Trading. You can bring the bronze skill shroom, silver skill shroom, or gold skill shroom the magistrate is seeking to the store. She will trade them for skill decals. Mushroom stew. Spend kill coins to drink some mushroom stew, which the mushroom magistrate has put her heart into making. As a bonus, a premium decal is always inside. These decals are different to standard ones. They will not disappear if the fighter there.
Oh, how I've been waiting for you, fellow believer, in the power of mushrooms. The secret of my success. The secret.
How many coins have you got? Zero.
Come again.
Well. DH service. Head up. Insurance company Direct Hell to offer a special service to support players. It's called DH service. You can access and sign up for it in the options menu. Remember, you need some of the special currency known as Death Metal to sign up though. Access the PlayStation Store, buy the Express Passes, you can also buy Death Metal and other helpful packs. We exchange Death Metal for Kill Coins. The exchange is 1 Death Metal to 5,000 Kill Coins. DH Express. They often shout, I want to climb the tower faster, or I want to play more efficiently. All that can be yours with the purchase of an Express Pass using Death Metal. After your purchase and use an Express Pass, the 3 services below will become available to you for 30 days. Once a day, you will receive unlimited decal as a login bonus. These skill decals have a variety of effects, including increasing your HP recovery or your XP or kill coin gains in the tower. You'll be able to use the Royal Elevator, unlike the normal elevator, which requires kill coins to operate. This extraordinary luxury elevator will transport you to your chosen floor of the tower free of charge. The number of slots in your death bank will increase. These extra spaces are called Royal Slots and will be marked with a crown icon. Stop using the Express Pass service, the items being held in the Royal Slots will be sent to your rewards box. Expanding storage. You can expand the storage room using Death Metal. For 2 Death Metal, you can buy another 10 slots. These slots will always be usable. Using Death Metal, you can reduce the time it takes to perform R&D or upgrades. At Choku Funsha? Funsha? Choku Funsha? Continue insurance. The manager will explain this to you at the appropriate time. Some long stuff here. Cell levels. That's Chogu Mancha. Commodore Suzuki. Commodore. Suzuki is the manager of the store. Give him the blueprints and materials that he can find in the tower and ask him to develop equipment. After the equipment has been developed, it can be mass-produced and sold in the store. Finding things to be sold in the store, however, is the player's responsibility. If you obtain blueprints, if you have blueprints obtained from the tower in your death bank, when you enter Choku, Funsha, Commodore Suzuki will analyse them for you. Purchasing. You can purchase weapons and armour. Once you have purchased a piece of equipment, it will be temporarily out of stock. Selling. Sell items in your possession. R&D. If you gather materials specified by a blueprint, you'll be able to request research and development. On such occasions, you will also require FP lithium obtained from defeating a specific enemy. The research development will take some time. When the research is finished, the items will appear in the shop and can be bought as many times as you need them. Strengthening. Once research has been conducted on a piece of equipment, you will be able to strengthen it. Material requires to be strengthened equipment. Okay. Storage chest. The storage chest is capable of holding any of the material it carries in their death bank, including equipment, mushrooms, and beasts. Beasts. Reward box. All quest rewards are placed in this box, in addition to login bonuses and presents from Captain Yotsuyama. Make sure to collect your prizes from here after you earn them. Picked up 4 skulls, so I've got 5. What are those things?
There's no glory, there is nothing, there's no love, nothing makes sense.
He nodded.
Welcome. Our express service is all you need to climb the tower. Bring me the materials and blueprints, and I'll make anything. However, I'll be needing some of your things in return. I use that energy to make the goods. Get it?
Contents of boxes are random. You must be excited to find out what's inside. So fling open any box you see. Thank you.
have to kill him before he kills you.
If your fighter exhausts their HP in this game, they will die and be resurrected as an enemy. Aetherification and retrieval. When a fighter dies, they will transform into an enemy roaming about on the floor on which they met their demise. Such fighters are called Aethers. If you assume control of a new fighter and defeat the Aether, they will be retrieved and stored in the fighter freezer. If you let them be and they defeat another player, the rewards will be sent to your rewards box. All enemies with names displayed in orange are haters. They might be one of your haters or a hater that was once a different player. In either case, they are far stronger than most of the other enemies you will face. Watch out for them. Quite interesting. Really rubbish with this gun though, I made a total mess of it. Stay in my elf. What's anyone for picking up here? John T. Wally from Albedo Eyes from Outer Space. Appear in the bottom center of the screen. When you see this icon, press X swiftly. Some animals can be captured after you begin by stomping them. Eating. Select the eat icon when you catch a beast to eat it. If you choose to store it in your deck, the number of beasts in your possession will be displayed in the flick box at the top right corner of the screen. You can flick the beast you wish to eat. With the touchpad and consume it by clicking the right side of the touchpad. Girl of beasts, right? Girl of the same name, mushrooms. Sprouting mushrooms. Mushrooms will sprout from the corpse of any animal that you kill by stomping or by any other method. The type of mushroom that grows will depend on the type of animal. Damn it.
mastery level. You defeat lots of enemies with a specific type of weapon. Your mastery level of that weapon will go up. Maximum level is 20, and you unlock sub moves you can use with L1 or R1, as well as new attacks and skill boosts, requiring APP ability points. Be rewarded to the weapon which dealt fine damage and defeat an enemy. Once you accumulate a number of points, your mastery level will increase. Mastery level not dependent on a fighter. The mastery level and APP points acquired are shared between fighters. Even if you switch to a low level fighter, you'll still be able to deal attacks corresponding to your mastery level. Stamps. There is always one stamp station on each level of the Tower of Barbs. You can stamp each one into the stamp section with the underworld Rolodex. It's possible to climb the tower without stamping, but you'll receive some rewards if you do. Pressing stamps. Once you access the stamp station, a stamp minigame will begin. Press X with good timing to press M for the stamps. No, don't stop. System of rear sub-elevators that run only between certain floors of the tower. For information on DH Express, please read the Bard's Bible 520 about DH services. Getting on and off, discover an elevator in the tower, turn the power switch on to allow the elevator to stop at that floor. Once you have done this, you can just use some kill coins and hop in the elevator anytime you wish to return to that floor, using elevators to return to the waiting room. Refresh yourself is also probably a good idea if you want a pleasant coin to listen. The Royal Elevator allows DH Express members to ride for free. Please tell Miss Torai, the elevator attendant, which floor you wish to go to. Maybe the social contract will be a bright spot on your lonely adventure. Thank you.
That's pretty cool. Reminds me of House of the Dead 1. Accessing the vanishing point fountain in the centre of the waiting room, you can suspend your game and return to the hated arcade. The waters of the fountain will also heal your wounds and soothe your troubled soul. The hated arcade, the arcade you're in now, at the Takadanobaba in the Shinjuku ward of Tokyo. The official Death Drive 128 is installed here. Uncle Death, age unknown, hobbies include skateboarding, video games and golf. Calls the player senpai as a mark of respect, gamer to gamer. Talking to him will activate the Death Drive 128, allowing you to resume the game. Meijin, 21 years old, a pro gamer, contracted as a character for the official image of the Death Drive. He is proficient in many games and has already cleared this one 6 times. He's usually busy playing fighting games, but will give the player various hints during the game. Naomi Detox, 17 years old, a typical high school junior who works at the counter of the hated arcade. She's constantly texting on her cell phone. If you open the Death Drive compatible laptop D-Mate on the counter, you can take on quests in the game. Mother Barb, unit which provides guidance on the Tower of Barbs via
diorama image. It will show information and explanations on the Tower of Barbs based on your progress in the game. Right. So let's go back to the arcade. Is that how you save it?
Sorry.
Oh, you playing that? Well, let me know if you have any questions. I'll give you some tips if I have the time.
Come on. I've been waiting. Put a motor in it, man.
That's us. Hopefully I'll be able to jump in from here. Hopefully it has saved. But thanks for tuning in, everybody, and I hope to see you again very soon for some more Let It Die. It's been the first ever. Bye! Bye!